at the rate of reaction, how they are differing from the pericyclic reactions. You see, all other reactions, they are taking place in certain states, sometimes in two states, sometimes three states, sometimes in multi states. But the pericyclic reactions, they are just taking place in one state without any intermediate. This is the main beauty of this reaction, pericyclic reactions. Now, there are three types of pericyclic reactions: electrocyclic reactions, cycloaddition reactions, and sigma-topic reactions. Electrocyclic, I'm just writing here, electrocyclic, then cycloaddition. I'm also writing on the board. You can note on your notebook. Addition and third one is sigma topic. Sigma topic reaction. So these are the three types, main types of the pericyclic reaction. Okay. So now, if you start from the electrocyclic reactions, now just divide the other one. So now we are attacking electrocyclic reaction. What are the electrocyclic reactions? How they are taking place? Which type of compounds the electrocyclic reaction takes place? They are electro. Let me write electrocyclic. Electrocyclic reactions. The converted into electrocyclic ring compound.
For example, we have a lot of show. See this
compound. Hello, sir.
What is the name of the compound?
Hello. Hello.
What's the name of this compound?
Hello, sir.
PGG. What is the name of this compound?
Sir. Sir, if battery mic on khulela and kicho band kar chhe to aane awaz bilkul kon do ache sir.
Good mic, I hikri bawa. You will unmute kar.
Sir, hi chokra khule bethan. Sir, chokra khule bethan.
Good mic, I hikri bawa. Jo baat mein jale bethwa.
Nahi sir, chokra khule bethan, chokra.
Bolu ji mic nahi ka. Wo mute kar chhe. Dekho, jagah board da nazar do chhe na.
जी जी सर
वो जो सिर्फ वीडियो खुले ला आज जो सब म्यूट चले वही जो मुझे आप के इन जी अनम्यूट है
ना सर वॉइस तो सही आ रही है लेकिन दो वॉइस
जी जगह हाथ में चले उठा मुझे मोबाइल इन जो अनम्यूट है बाकी जगह बोर्ड नजर तो ये म्यूटेड है इन जो ऑडियो म्यूट है ये कोई मोड मोबाइल बस
ना सर ये छोकरा खुले और उनको जो आवाज होते
सर ब्याह छोकरा खुले बैठा है उन्होंने जो आवाज सुनी खुले खुले देता उन्होंने जो आवाज पूछे
यस सर वे फिल्म था आला था मछली लगन सर
सर असल
ओपो F9 कह रहा
व्हिच कंपाउंड फ्रॉम दिस वन
साइक्लोब्यूटेन
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 साइक्लोब्यूटेन साइक्लोब्यूटेन साइक्लो
ब्यूटीन
ठीक है
जी सर
जे के नगर ही कड़ो कंपाउंड है ही नगर के कंपाउंड ही कड़ो कंपाउंड वही कंपाउंड
वीडियो पास थियो सर
हले पे बा
वीडियो पास थियो
ना ना सर हले पे
ना सर हले पे
हले पे सर
जॉइन बैक ज्वाइन पे कंदा हो ना इनने क्या ओके कर और कालू पे तो कालू के बंद हो गया ही कपा ही नजर जब लगी कपा
यस सर
1 2 3 4 5 6 1 3 5
ट्राई
एग्जैक्ट 135 ट्राई
135 एग्जैक्ट ट्राइंग
हां यस 1 3 5 1 5
एग्जैक्ट ट्राइंग
5 एग्जैक्ट ट्राइंग नाउ यू सी व्हाट वाज हैपनिंग हियर This compound butadiene was converted into cyclohexene. That the ring was formed, and one pi bond was consumed, and one new sigma bond was formed.
Yes, sir.
And here, okay, now you see here. If these electrons comes over here, then these comes over here, these comes over here. So what happens? We will have again ring. Ring formation take place. Here, this pi bond has been consumed to form one new sigma bond, and these electrons comes over here to form the pi bond. Here, this shift over here to form pi bond. Now, what is the name of this compound?
1 2 3 4.
Upar wala cyclopentene nahi bane.
Hexadiene.
1 3.
Hexadiene.
1 3.
Hexadiene.
Cyclohexadiene. 1 3 1 3 cyclohexadiene because now ring 1 3 1
sir
time khatam
diyo sir time khatam diyo sir
wo
na sir shuru kar bhai
sir
ta continue kari se bola sir automatic shuru kiye ji ji sir 1 3
cyclohexadiene
sir thi na ji sir ओके साइक्लो पेंटीन
बनेगा
साइक्लो पेंटीन कैसे बनेगा भाई 1 2 3 4 5 6 कार्बन 6 कार्बन 6 कार्बन है तो पेंटीन कैसे बनेगा 6 कार्बन और क्या कहते हैं हां ये पेंटीन क्यों बनेगा एक हां 1 2 3 4 नाम है 4 कार्बन ये जितने कार्बन कार्बन नंबर ऑफ कार्बन रिमेन सेम ओनली वन डबल बॉन्ड इज कंज्यूमड एंड कन्वर्टेड टू सिंगल बॉन्ड There are two double bond. Now there is single bond. Instead of two double bond, here is one single bond, one double bond. Here instead of three double bond, now in product there are two double bond and one single bond. So now we say one pi bond in each product, in each reaction, one pi bond is consumed for one new sigma bond. Again here see three double bonds means three pi bonds. Now here two pi bond and one sigma bond. So now we say total number of here. See here two pi bonds. Here two pi. Here one pi bond plus one sigma bond. Or we can say here two pi minus one. Or two minus one pi bond or one sigma bond plus one sigma bond. Similarly here one only sigma bond new sigma bond is formed. One pi bond is consumed.
Yes, sir.
So this is the one example of electrocyclic reaction. It is electrocyclic reaction. Is it okay? Electrocyclic reaction. This is the simple two examples of electrocyclic reaction. As I told you, pericyclic reactions are of three types: electrocyclic, cyclic reaction, and sigmatropic. So this, if you talk about the electrocyclic, then these are the examples of electrocyclic. So what is happening? The one compound is directly converted into cyclic compound without any intermediate, and overall one pi bond has been sacrificed. If from here, if you break up this bond, if this bond directly bond to the B, and if this bond comes over here, then everything remains same. Number of ring remains same. Here a cyclic compound, another cyclic compound. What is the difference? You see here D, this D remain as it is. This H, the double bond comes over here. this comes for this is consumed. So now we will have here compound. Say this compound will be formed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One more part. And now what from here this D is shifted. When from where the D is shifted, you just here say one D comes over here. This is the main action. You see, from here this bond is broken up. Bond from and the D from here, deuterium from here, or any group. Now just I am giving the example of D. Otherwise, you can give the example of any group. Now it is shifted from here to here. The ring position remains same. Double bond was there. Two double bonds. Here two double bonds. 6, 7 member ring. Here 7 member ring. Only this group is changed from change the position from here to here. In this case, number of ring is same, number of pi bonds are same, number of sigma bonds are same. In this conversion is known as sigma trapic reaction. Here is the example of sigma trapic reaction. Now another example of sigma trapic reaction is, let me give the example of another example of sigma trapic reaction. Let me write one compound. If you see this compound. Now, what is the name of this compound?
Benzene.
Can you give the name of this compound? Benzene. Now, if I put here CHO CH3, then this is known as
anisole.
Anisole or
methoxybenzene.
Methoxybenzene or phenoxymethane. Okay. So now, simply you say if the benzene is the parent compound. If the benzene is parent compound, it is methoxybenzene. Now again, if you increase the chain, now this compound is known as
ethoxybenzene.
Ethoxybenzene. Again, if you put your third carbon, then
propoxybenzene.
Okay. Now again, if I put your double bond, then any other group. Now this will be known as
propinoxybenzene.
Here is allyl group. Allyl or vinyl connected to propinyl. Which propinyl? 2-propinyl. Now you see here, if this group, this may be an H, this may be any other group. That is actually propinyl. Which propinyl? 2-propinyl. It is phenyl. Phenyl 2-propinyl ether. Or we say 2-propanyloxybenzene. Okay. Now if this undergo the same sigma trapic reaction. Now if these electrons come over here. Yes, same compound is containing. If these electrons comes over here, means this bond will be broken up. Then these electrons come over here to form the bond between this carbon and this carbon. These electrons will be shifted over here. Then a new compound is formed. Which compound is formed? Now you see here, this bond remain as it is. Now this bond come over here to form the bond between this CH, this R remain as it is. This is converted single bond, and this is now converted double bond. This new compound is formed. Can you name this compound? Is it 1 टू थ्री फोर फाइव सिक्स विदाउट दिस वी से इट इज टू फोर साइक्लोहेक्साडाइनोन इट इज कीटोन साइक्लिक कीटोन at the sixth position this group is known allyl allyl are 2 propenyl or oh, 6 propenyl 6 propenyl 2 4 cyclohexadienone this is the ketone but it is not aromatic ketone now this state is known as the conversion of this compound into this compound is number of ring remains same, number of pi bonds remain also same. How many pi bonds are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. You'll see 1, 2, 3, 4. Only the rearrangement, the positions of double bonds or pi bonds is changed. Otherwise, the number of pi bonds remains same. So this special step is known as sigma tropic reaction. Once this product is formed, now the if you say now if you take here use the acid catalyst then what happens when you if you use the acid catalyst then what happens here is the H if it comes over here then these recarbonyl come over here and this will pick up the hydrogen so if phenol is formed plus remains same that is now you see here ring here becomes OH side ring is there but now it is aromatized now aromatization take place then you write in this way or just straight line it is one and same thing so which of this compound is formed 1 2 3 4 5 6 which is 2 allyl phenol is formed ortho two position is also another ortho तो आर्थो एलाइल फिनोल आर टू टू एलाइल फिनोल टू एलाइल इज आल्सो नोन एज टू टू और आर्थो टू प्रोपिनाइल आर्थो टू प्रोपिनाइल फिनोल इज आल्सो नोन एज आर्थो आर टू एलाइल फिनोल तो नाउ दिस इज द लास्ट स्टेप इट इज नाउ एसिड कैटलाइज दिस इज नॉट सिग्मोट्रॉपिक रिएक्शन just conversion of this A into B is known as sigmatropic reaction in which same number of pi bonds same number of ring remains same only the rearrangement of positions of pi bond changing this is sigmatropic once sigmatropic reaction takes place then this can undergo the ionic reaction so these are the two simplest examples of sigmatropic reaction now we are coming to the three examples of pericyclic reaction so now we can say what are the common features that is sigma pericyclic reaction how main differences between the sigma pericyclic reaction ionic or periodical or radical reactions now these are the concerted pericyclic reactions they are concerted you know concerted concerted reaction means they are taking place in one step or either they are taking place in one step or the attack takes place from the back side those reactions which are taking place in one step they are concerted reaction and mostly not all in mostly when the concerted reaction takes place the attack always takes place from the back side so now in this case these are the concerted reaction means they do not involve the addition or elimination reaction no role so we say here no role of acid no role of any base no role of any electrophile no role of any nucleophile so this is one feature sir two feature number one is concerted reaction number two is no role of any catalyst that acid catalyst or base catalyst or electrophile or nucleophile third feature is here we say no role of catalyst we can use catalyst these are commonly catalysts are here either heat is used or light when heat is used we say it is thermally catalyzed reaction the when the light is used it is photochemically catalyzed reaction So now, otherwise, no any chemical, no any external chemical is needed to undergo this reaction. Now, third feature of this reaction is, third common feature of this reaction is, no any significant change in rate take place when we change the polarity. No significant change take place on addition of on changing the polarity of solvent. You know, if you remember the SN1, SN2, if you change the polarity, if you increase the polarity of the solvent, reaction rate was increased. In case of SN1, SN2, polarity of polar solvent, which hydroxide solvent, when it was increased, rate of reaction was increased. Similarly, in SN2 reaction, the polarity of when it was increased, rate of reaction was increased. But here in this case, in pericyclic reaction, either you increase the polarity of hydroxide solvent, there is no effect. There is no effect on the rate of reaction. Now this is the third. Now fourth feature is, if you remember the SE reaction, electrophilic SE reaction, electrophilic substitution reaction, in which there was effect of salt, added salt. But here if you add the salt, no effect is observed for addition of external salt. If you add any salt, no effect of added salt will take place. So this is the common fourth feature. The fifth feature, here say no again when we say the how it can differentiate from the radical. No effect of any radical interim. If you remember chain reaction, there was three steps: initiation, last was termination. What was the second step? In which the initiation was taking place by the use of either UV light or any peroxide. So that was the initiation. Initiation was taking place by the initiator. Here there is no role of any initiator. This is the fifth point. Now sixth and last is actually reaction only need here, as I told you, either heat or light. Other reactions mostly they are using the catalyst, and here catalyst we can use heat or light. When you use the heat, then triangle is used. This is simple when reaction is using the heat as a catalyst. When light, then we use the symbol H nu, that is photons. So if heat is used, the reaction is thermally catalyzed reaction. If the light is used, then we say it is known as photochemically catalyzed reaction. Now these are the common features of pericyclic reaction. Now we are coming to the what we mean by what is this one?
Sir, fifth one. Repeat kijo, sir.
जी भाव
फिफ्थ केड़ो लिखा हुआ सर
फिफ्थ
जी सर
फिफ्थ हो नो रोल ऑफ एनी रेडिकल इनिशिएटर
ठीक सर
चेन रिएक्शन वी आर नाउ वी आर यूजिंग द इनिशिएटर आइदर फ्री रेडिकल आर एन यूवी लाइट बट हियर देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ एनी इनिशिएटर ओके स्पेशली इनिशिएटर इज यूज्ड इन द चेन रिएक्शन इज अ टाइप ऑफ फ्री रेडिकल रिएक्शन Generally, radical reaction we say called a free radical reaction. So free radical reaction, they need the catalyst starting that initiator. But here there is no need of any initiator. Now,
sir, थोड़ा time जो photo कर दिया था board जो. हाँ. सर थोड़ा time जो हम photo कर दिया था board जो.
हाँ. अच्छा अच्छा तो हमको तो बुझाएगा ग्राम मुखर खबर कौन पे साहब तो का बीरा दोस्त जो का फोटोग्राफ समझ में बिन जैसे होता मुझे बोल ठीक है
जी जी ठीक
टू टाइप्स ऑफ रिएक्शन विच आर आइदर थर्मली थर्मली कैटलाइज्ड और फोटोकेमिकली इधर ओके आइदर इट इज थर्मली कैटलाइज्ड रिएक्शन और दे आर फोटोकेमिकली सो व्हाट इज द मेन डिफरेंस एक्चुअली द डिफरेंस इज इन व्हेन थर्मली कैटलाइज्ड रिएक्शन the reaction becomes stereospecific when the reaction is thermally catalyzed it is differing from other reactions that is photochemically when the thermally catalyzed reaction it is stereospecific and when light is used then another was stereoselective reaction this becomes now if you remember the one of the example SN2 versus SN2 do you remember this SN2 and SN1 in SN2 SN1 reaction was taken in 2 steps SN2 reaction was taken place in 1 step SN1 in 2 steps SN2 in 1 step so SN1 SN2 which was taken place in 1 step in which the attack was taking place from the back side a reaction was proceeding through the formation of transition state and when transition state formed the attack was taking place from the back side and stereo chemistry of the product was always it was inversion take place SN1 the retention as well as the inversion but the majority of the product major product was the retention little bit was also inversion but in case of SN2 reaction 100% there was inversion the configuration was inverted that was the example of simple example of the stereospecific reaction so we said when thermally connected that is stereospecific now another way is we say when either reaction is taking place by thermally or electrically now here you see if you carry out the reaction if you supply the energy to the electron which is now present in the ground state then what happens the reaction get absorb the energy and it jumps from the ground state to the higher state and that higher state is known excited state when heat is used the electrons remain in the ground state but they becomes vibrationally excited they come in the vibrationally excited state while in photochemical catalyzed reaction the reaction becomes electronically excited do you remember this now let me write here if we have reaction the ground state two electrons if you thermochemical now what happens if this molecule is bonding molecule or bonding orbital another anti bonding bondings are more stable than anti bonding if you heat it then what happens they can absorb but they remain in the bonding orbital the electrons remain in the bonding orbitals but they are vibrationally excited but if you use light then what happens they can absorb the light and they can jump one electron from the ground state to the excited state so now this is known as electronically excited state this is vibrationally excited state this is electronically excited state electronically excited so this is the main difference and but this is also anti bonding this is bonding same this thermal this is photochemical this here heat is used here photons are electricity is used so this is the main difference between these two how the difference now so just in the excitation. There's a difference. Now we can say this in the here the electron here remain the ground state. Here they go in the excited state. So now it is also singlet. This is also singlet. This is ground singlet. This is excited singlet. Singlet. Ground state singlet. And this is excited. Now which is more stable? Now if you see here, now one thing here, you see, when the electrons are shifted from ground state to the excited state, see, one electron remain in the ground state, another come in the excited state, but spins of both are changed. Now there is third situation, inter system crossing. Another inter system crossing, in which what happens, sometimes the ground state excited remains same, but here it has, when you say one electron comes from ground state to excited state, the spin remains same. Here spin is changed, here spin remains same. So here if it is clockwise, again here also excited electron will also have clockwise, right? Same spin. Now this becomes, this is known as inter system crossing system is known as a triplet excited state. That is said as a triplet excited. Now we have three states. One is bonding, you see, vibrationally ground state singlet, here electronically excited, that is excited singlet, and third one inter system crossing, in which the spin is remaining same. So now it is known as, now it is triplet excited state. Now here you see antibonding up here, up antibonding is empty, ground state is full, here ground state is half, here excited is half, here inter crossing system again half. One electron is lying in the ground state, one electron is lying in the excited state. Now one thing, again repeat, I mean, here the spin in case of excited singlet remaining same, sorry, here spin remaining same, inter crossing change. Now we have three states. Now we have three states, which one? Vibrationally excited singlet or ground state singlet, then excited singlet is set, third one is triplet excited singlet. Now which one is more stable,
sir?
Ji
sir, ma'am, wait kar rahi class ke liye.
Chalo theek hai, aaj yahan khatam, kal yahi se start karenge.
Yes sir.
theek hai.
Yes sir.
aaj yahi pe sab kar dete जी, अभी कल का सुबह ने गंशा लेकर शुरू करना है.
जी 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 सर,
ठीक, ओके,
अल्लाह सर, अल्लाह हाफिज सर, भाई जाओ,
अल्लाह हाफिज,
अल्लाह हाफिज, अल्लाह हाफिज, अटेंड अटेंड जो है सिनेप साहब ये उठ के बोल जा
सर, सर उठ चले,
ठीक है, उठ जा,
क्लास में आ जा, मैं वेट कर रही
हूं. ठीक है, मैं लो, अल्लाह हाफिज, अल्लाह. Oh,